ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. This was the scene a few minutes ago. The dog pound in full roar as their Browns emerge from their tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
For Tampa Bay.
Here's the punter, Bradley Pinion, on to get us started. And off we go from Cleveland. And this carries into the end zone. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. For Mayfield and finding the tight end Hooper. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating, there he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete. I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Mayfield looks to throw. Eluding the... And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. The sack by the Super Bowl champion and Pro Bowler, Jason Pierre-Paul.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board.
Here's Mickens to return. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And that will come the offense as they take over.
At their own 27-yard line.
And they'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A 6-yard pickup.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
4 yards remain for 2nd down. Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. A handoff to Fournette. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
The tackle made.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
On 2nd down, here's Fournette. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 11 yards there, 1st down.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
So a good run by Fournette. Now another 1st and 10. Now Brady. And a big loss pass here as he's taken down. Myles Garrett able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. A long ways to go here on second down. Here's Gabbert now. They'll find Miller. That's complete. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And for the Browns, a nickel set here on third down. Gronkowski, and they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 29-yard line. We're scoreless after one. At the 24-yard line after a gain of five.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Second down and five. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
A 3-yard gain on the play brings up third down.
Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on third and 2. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski, that's caught. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. Brady on target to Gronk. First down, Buccaneers.
First down, Tampa Bay.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now a first down carry by Jones. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady gain.
Ball sits on the 10, second and 5. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll look to make it 3 for 3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. Try and run for it with Jones. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run. run. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. He's got a first down and more past the 30. And all the way inside the 35 before he goes out of bounds. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Mayfield tosses one complete to Landry, and inside the 20 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
First down.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, Mayfield. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll run with Chubb, and he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Give him 3 on the gain there, second and goal. They'll give it to Chubb, and he takes this one in for a Browns score. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. So a late touchdown here just before the half, and that obviously changes the dynamic of this game.
Yeah, in a couple of ways, partner, because they've been shut out up until this point. So now at least they go into the locker room, and Uncle Mo may be creeping over to their side to talk to them a little bit. And second, they're right back in the football game, an extra point away from tying things up.
Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops, and if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Second and 5. At the
5 yards remain on second down. Brady. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
Buccaneers.
First down, Brady.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, this will be a 41-yarder. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And this carries into the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And this is picked up by the Browns. So that's a solid start to the second half. You come out of the lockers losing, thinking you're kicking it away, not going to have it, but boom, the fumble, they get it right back.
I don't know whether they even drew that up on the board or was it just said, but they had to have it. They needed a spark to get them going here in the second half, and they got it right away.
So now, just like that, things change dramatically. It's first and goal. Now he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. From the 2 now, second and goal.
Pick up a 2. Brings up 7.
They'll try again with Chubb. And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Nick Chubb, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And once again, the Browns are back in front. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there. But 2 TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
First and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 11 yards there. First down.
First down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. At one, and it's Brady looking downfield for Godwin. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
Third quarter action. Appreciate you joining us from Cleveland, Ohio. Second and 10. Here's a give to Fournette.
get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
I actually love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And Brady's throw there, incomplete. Brady's pass. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Leonard Fournette. Fournette fighting through. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 12 yards there and a first down. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they had three tight ends in on that set.
And these guys are punching really well. I use boxing analogies a lot. A lot of coaches have told me that when you line up to run the football, it's 10 fist fights along the line of scrimmage, right? You've got to win your share. These three tight ends, they almost always win their fist fights.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.